Summit Teacher 7, Mr. Bear here. Today I'm going to be showing you how to install Neverware's CloudReady OS, which is just like Chrome OS or Chromium, right on this Windows 10 PC. Now this is a newer HP Stream laptop and it has some limitations. It's been running Windows 10 and it's been doing it very, very slowly. Now the CPU, RAM, as well as the eMMC storage is all soldered right onto the main board of this unit, and you cannot upgrade those components. So last night I took the whole thing apart and I took this picture of the motherboard. And as you can see, everything is soldered on. Nothing is upgradable there. And on this particular machine, it's even difficult to get into the BIOS settings so that you can tell it to boot up from a USB flash drive. So let's get started with the lesson. So here we are on the HP Stream laptop. We're going to look at the system properties here. So I'm going to right click on the start menu and then go up to system. This is the main reason for installing the Chrome OS on this particular unit, because it is very, very slow. And right away you can see how slow this machine is. I just clicked on system and it's taking a long time just to start that up. This particular unit I did loan out to a number of different students. They would take it home and they couldn't believe how slow it was as far as trying to open up or start an application, do other things. It was just kind of like ridiculous. So let's see what kind of processor we have. We have the Intel Celeron, the N3050. That's running at 1.6 gigahertz. Now, for a Windows machine, that is a very slow processor. But that same processor runs very quickly on a Chromebook. So that's one of the reasons why we're switching over. To better illustrate just where the performance sits on this particular processor, I went to cpubenchmark.net and I pulled the benchmark numbers or the performance numbers for that processor as well as another processor, and I made this Google Sheet chart. Now on the very first one we see the Intel Celeron N3050, 0.6 gigahertz. That's the processor that's found in the HP Windows 10 machine. And it's running at 1.6 gigahertz. This other one here is the Intel Pentium, the N4200 at 1.1 gigahertz, and that's found in my newer Acer Chromebook 15, the CB515, that I've been using for a few months. Now, if you just look at the gigahertz speed, you'd say, oh, that Windows machine, well, that would be faster. It's a faster performing processor, 1.6 gigahertz versus 1.1 gigahertz. But in fact, the exact opposite is true. For if we look at the CPU benchmark or the performance mark right here, we'll soon see that the one that's running at 1.6 gigahertz, the one that's found in the Windows machine, scores less than 1,000. And the one that's in the Chromebook is actually scoring closer to a little bit more than 2,000 on the benchmark. And here's a little chart just illustrating that for us. So that's one of the issues that this window is having as far as performance. It has a very slow processor. Now it's true that just changing the operating system from Windows to a different one is not going to make that processor any faster. It's not going to create a faster processor. But what is true is that Windows is more demanding on the processors. So if you're running Windows, you do need a faster processor or a better performing processor. And CloudReady OS or even Chrome OS or Chromium, they require less as far as processor performance. Let's go on now to its memory. The other thing that we have is we only have 2 gigs of RAM, and just let you know that 2 gigs of RAM on a Windows machine is not enough. In fact, there's been a number of people who have been asking me how much RAM is enough. Well, that really depends on which operating system that you're running. So if you're running Windows 10, or even Windows 7, I would recommend at least 8 gigs or more of RAM. Now, if you're running on a Chromebook, 4 gigs of RAM is enough. I even upgraded one of these Acer 710s with 16 gigs of RAM, and I did not see any difference in the performance. Now, the thing is, I was running 25 tabs with videos going and everything else, and basically everything was running smoothly. It didn't use 16 gigs of RAM. It didn't need it. 4 gigs of RAM was enough. So now that we have all those issues out of the way, we need to get the operating system. So we go to neverware.com/free download. And there's the link. I also have the link in the description. And once you're at that website there, this page will load up and we need to get the Cloud OS operating system. So let's say we're using a Windows machine. Click on download the USB maker, and there in the lower corner, you'll be downloading this exe file. You don't have to unzip it or anything. Once it downloads, all you gotta do is click it and run this application. This is now the time to put in your USB thumb drive into the USB port. Now it's going to erase all the data or anything that's on this one, so it's best to use an empty one, but you don't have to. Just know that everything will be erased. Now go down here and click this icon, and this app will load. It says, welcome to the CloudReady USB creation utility for CloudReady. And you need at least an 8 gig to 16 gig USB stick and about 20 minutes to do this. Click on next. And it recommends a 64-bit. Go next. And this next step, the selected device will be permanently erased and turned into a CloudReady installer. Now to get the CloudReady operating system on this machine, we have to turn on the power and connect an external USB keyboard and then press the escape key. When we press the escape key, we'll get up to the startup menu, and then we want to go to F10. After pressing the F10, we get into the BIOS utility. Now there's a few things that we need to change here. That's all into system configuration. So use your arrow keys to go into system configuration and then go down to boot options. And then from here, go down to secure boot. And then at that point, hit enter and then choose disable. So now secure boot is disabled. Then go down to the UEFI boot order and change it so the OS boot manager doesn't load first, but we need the USB disk it on key USB hard drive or hard disk that needs to be first. You can use the F6 or F5 keys to change those around. After changing those, you can press the escape key twice and find the exit saving changes. Click on yes. You'll then see this message. Go ahead and just key in the number that you see there, such as 2185. Hit the enter key and it'll complete the change for you. Okay, now you want to make sure that you have your USB drive that has the operating system on there plugged into the USB port. There you go. And now you're going to see it says CloudReady. This is the first screen that you're going to get. Now, first off, before you go in and click on down in the corner and say install CloudReady, before you do that, you want to make sure that CloudReady operating system actually works on your laptop without giving any issues. So let's go ahead and just click on let's go and then connect to your Wi-Fi. After connecting to your Wi-Fi, you want to log into your Google account. And again, this is just a test to make sure that the sound, the Wi-Fi, and video, everything works properly without a hitch. So you need to log into your Google account and put in your password. After putting in your password, hitting next, then you'll see this screen where it says, please wait. And you'll say, howdy, and your name. Now at this time you can go into release notes or read more about it with a tour or get started. We're just going to close off these little windows here and let you know that this is the home version and it is free. I don't recommend the other version. The other version would be for school. So let's go over here and let's start up the Chrome browser. Already I see my bookmarks. If I go here to the app launcher here and I click it, notice already I'm getting a lot of my apps are installing on this device. There they are, they're installing right now. And this is all being ran from the USB thumb drive. It's not being ran on the hard drive yet because I haven't installed it. So let's go in and see if it plays a video. And let's see if it plays this video here. So already we can hear it's It has the sound. So let's see if it has sound. There we go. Okay, I'm gonna hit the space bar here and pause this. Now, so we can see that the sound works, the video works. Let's see if it still works without any glitches when I go full screen.
On your Chromebook using VLC.
Okay, so it's working very well there for sound. The Wi-Fi works, video works. So far, so good. So if there's other applications or other apps that you really use a great deal, you want to go down and load those and test them to make sure that they do work on this hardware with that particular operating system. Once you're happy that everything's going to be working well, go over to the lower corner, click it, and then choose Install CloudReady. Once you click it there, this window will come up. It says install here. Now the only option that we have on the current version of the CloudReady OS is to erase the entire hard drive and install the CloudReady OS. Now this will take about 20 minutes. Once it's done, the machine will shut down. Unplug the jump drive and let's turn it on. The CloudReady splash screen, and now we see the welcome screen. Click on Let's Go, choose your network, and put in your password. After putting in your password, click on Connect. Now you'll be installing updates, and now sign into your Chromebook. You'll be using your Google account to sign in. Click Next, and then key in your password, and then click Next. Then you'll be synchronizing your preferences. And you'll say, howdy Daniel. You can take a tour there, learn more about it. You can read the release notes. Basically, this is, they use the same things that you see in the Chrome OS. For as far as updates and security updates, they're usually about 2 weeks behind. And so that's why we see Chromium OS upgrade to version 63 there. Close that out after reading those notes, and you will see your applications being installed here. So people have asked, are there differences between the Chrome OS and the Chromium OS? Well, your apps play, everything else plays fine. I did find a big difference though. When I go to daily motion.com and try to play one of the videos. Let me demonstrate. So I'll try to play on this video here. And I get an error message. It says, please update your browser or try a different one. Well, I've tried updating the browser. I get the same error. I even tried running different browsers. You can install different browsers within the Chromium OS, and all of them gave me the same error from this operating system. So unfortunately, Daily Motion doesn't work, as well as some of the Korean drama websites I tried. But YouTube works, as well as your apps. So let's try one of these apps here. Let's try Cut the Rope. Let's choose Play. And so the app plays. So let me see if Screencastify works. So we're testing the app called Screencastify to see if it'll record my desktop with the audio and the video here. And as you can see, it works fine there. And this is the that system information, by the way. Oh, here's the name of the operating system, Chromium OS, and other information about it. And now we're testing the webcam to see if the operating system has access to the webcam. Again, I'm using the Screencastify app, and it looks like it's recording. So, wonderful. So the only problem that we saw was it didn't play Daily Motion videos, and some of the other Korean dramas that I tried earlier. Well, there you have it. You now know how to install the Chromium OS right onto a Windows computer. Now, I just want to emphasize that you do want to test it first before actually installing it and making sure that you don't have any bugs to worry about later. On this video, please give it a thumbs up, share, and comment down below because I love to read your comments. Thank you again and bye-bye.